And one night, I don't know if it was 1940 or 1941, the catcher was riding me on the team we were, and he said, "Oh, yeah, son, just go sit down." And I ran the count up, I had a pretty good eye. They put that soap on pretty fast, you know, the fast pitch. And finally, I ran the count up, I think 3-2, and he said, "What are you going to do, Yates?" I said, "I'm going to get a line drive right out between the shortstop and the third baseman." I was a pull hitter. I batted right-handed, but I threw left-handed. And so the next time, I said, "Oh, that shortstop and third baseman should be playing close together." The next time, I ran the count up again. And what are you going to do this time, Yates? He said, "I'm going to get a double right down the third baseline." Sure enough, line drive right down the third baseline. And he said, "Oh, that third baseman should have been playing right on the line." And he said, "What are you going to do this time?" I said, "I'm going to get a triple out between the center fielder and the left fielder out against the ball." And that was in the largest ballpark in the United States or world, I think. They could play one minor league baseball game, and they could play two football games and two softball games, and they would never interfere with one another. It was Clemens Field in Hannibal, and it was in, believe it or not, back in the 40s or 30s, something like that. And so sure enough, the third time when I came up, I said, "I'm going to get a hit out between the center fielder and left fielder for a triple. And I hit, for that night I had two singles, two doubles, and a triple, everything but a home run for a cycle. Isn't that coming? And we won that game 9-7.
Because of who?
And I drove in three runs, I scored three runs, and I made two sensational catches.